Hey everybody, we are back and live for part two of our rudiment roundup here. If you've already checked out my first video, you saw a breakdown of the first category of the PAS, Percussive Arts Society International Drum Rudiments, the roll rudiments. So, if you haven't done so already, feel free to check out that video where we really break those down. This video here, we're going to break down the smallest category there is, the diddle rudiments. Which, there's a little bit of overlap in that, because there are some diddle rudiments over here in the flam category and the drag category, but since those also have flams or drags on them, they are classified over here as well. But we're going to talk about these four rudiments here, the diddle rudiments. Some might argue they're the simplest rudiments. They're amazing though. They're fantastic rudiments. They're a lot of fun to play and they have a million applications, whether it be on concert drum playing, rudimental drum playing, drum set in particular. Oh man, diddle rudiments, single paradiddles, double paradiddles, paradiddle diddles. They are all fantastic rudiments to play on drum sets for all sorts of different grooves and beats, fills and solos. Love the variety of sound that can be generated from diddle rudiments on a drum set just by using those sticking patterns. Really, really great stuff. Maybe I'll make another video some other day explaining how to do all that, but you could use your imagination. Once you've learned all these rudiments, if you're a set player or becoming one, sit at your kit and fool around with paradiddles and double paradiddles and put your hands at different parts of your drum set. Maybe do some fills down your toms and things like that. You can do some really cool things with that. But anyway, the diddle rudiments. Let's get at it, shall we? Here we go. So first up is the single paradiddle. It is just a group of four notes, one, two, three, four, with a specific sticking of right, left, right, right, or left, right, left, left. The great thing about the name paradiddle, and a lot of these rudiments as a matter of fact, is that the name fits the rudiment. You can literally say paradiddle while you play it, because paradiddle is four syllables and you need to hit the drum four times. Whoa, coincidence, right? So, and the great thing is when you say diddle, that's the double hit of the one hand. So paradiddle, you know, right, left, right, right. Paradiddle, or paradiddle, left, right, left, left. Please be aware of the accents that are on these rudiments, and they're typically only on the beginning. Sometimes in literature, you'll see them on multiple, but for the rudiment itself, it's only one accent per right at the beginning. So let's play some paradiddles. So right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. Also notice that when my hand is doing the double hit, so the right, right, my left is lifting up in anticipation of coming back down for the next paradiddle, or prepping, if you will. I'm prepping that next stroke, so paradiddle. As I do the diddle, I'm raising this guy back or pulling it back, whatever you want to say, getting it ready for that next attack. All right, the double paradiddle is literally, it's a little bit of a misnaming, if you will. Double paradiddle, you might think, oh, it's two paradiddles put together. Not exactly. It does contain a paradiddle. If you look right here, there's an right, left, right, right. Yeah, it's a paradiddle. But at the beginning of it is an additional right, left. So it's a paradiddle with two additional hits at the beginning, if that makes sense. And once again, the name matches up syllabically, however you want to say that, with the number of strokes. So double, here, I'll do it this way. Double paradiddle. And once again, when I say diddle, it's that double of the one hand. So double paradiddle. Double paradiddle. Okay, again, only one accent though. Don't go double, right? It's not two accents. Double pair, right? No, we don't want that here, you know? Okay, double pair, no, just the one. Here we go. Double pair. okay? The triple paradiddle. Careful on this one. You cannot say triple paradiddle. Why, you may ask? Well, because triple paradiddle has the same number of syllables as double paradiddle. So if you say triple paradiddle, you're really going to play a double. And that would be wrong. So you can't do that. So I like to tell my students to say, this is triple paradiddle. By saying this is, it gives you the additional two syllables for the additional two hits that happen at the beginning. So you're going to say, this is triple paradiddle. Or right, left, right, left, right, left, right, right. So here we go with the triple paradiddle. This is, so you're going to be like this. This is triple paradiddle. This is triple paradiddle. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, left. So here we go with some triple paradiddles. Okay, and last but not least in the diddle category is number 19, the single paradiddle diddle. And once again, the name is exactly what it says it is. Paradiddle diddle. So you're taking a regular single paradiddle, paradiddle, and you're adding another diddle with the other hand. So paradiddle diddle. This also means that it cannot alternate. You're going to perpetually kick back to your other hand, to the same hand rather. So paradiddle diddle, paradiddle diddle. Or you can start on your left hand, paradiddle diddle, paradiddle diddle. So here we go with paradiddle diddles. Okay, well there you have it folks, there's our four diddle rudiments, the single paradiddle, the double paradiddle, the triple paradiddle, and the single paradiddle diddle. Have a great day!